Hi, everybody. Welcome to day one. Today, I wanted to talk about us moms feeling like we're being selfish if we're taking time out for ourselves. It's so easy to get wrapped up into the, take care of everybody first, and if there is enough time for me at the end of the day, I'll work out. Well, is there ever enough time at the end of the day to work out or to read or to work on that project you've been wanting to get to, or write your blog or write your book that you've been meaning to write, whatever it is that you've been meaning to do, we need to do those things. We need to do those first. And I'm not saying that, screw everybody else and you just, do what you need to do and they can fend for themselves. Of course not. But what I'm saying is to make sure you plan your day to get those things done, to do what it is that you want to do to feel good about yourself. I try to work out in the morning before my kids get up and the family gets up, but it doesn't work. I stay up too late at night and I just can't get up that early in the morning. I already have to be to work by 7. So it just feels like I'm getting up in the middle of the night to work out. And so I know that I have to do it when I get home. And so as soon as I get home, I, get the girls settled and I get them a snack and get them started on homework. And then I head upstairs to work out. Now tonight that didn't happen. My other daughter needed to get to soccer practice and I just didn't get to stuff on time. There's other things I was doing. And so I know now after I do this video, I have to do it. But I know for me that if I don't get that workout in, I'm a grumpy Gus. I really want to do this for me, and I feel so much better. I'm happier. I've relieved the tension and the stress of the day, and I'm relaxed, and I can go into the evening so much better and so much nicer because, I've taken care of myself. I've done something for me. And, you just feel like you're in more control of yourself when you've done something. You're happier, the kids are happier, your hubby's happier, you feel better about yourself, you have higher self-esteem, you have, more confidence going into the evening or the day, depending on when you work out. If you are a stay-at-home mom, I know you're doing 100 million things, so I know it's still not easy to fit it in. But try to get it done during the day when, the kids are taking a nap or the kids are at school, depending on the ages of your kids. And then you have the whole evening with the family once your husband gets home from work, if that's what, how your family is situated. However it works, fit something in for you. It doesn't have to be fitness. It doesn't have to be anything like that. It can be the book you're trying to write, the blog you're trying to make, the craft projects that you like to do, the sewing that you want to get to. Whatever it is, do those things for you. Don't say in, whenever I have time, because we will never have time. There's always something in the way. So do stuff for you and you will feel better about it. So that is just what I want you to do. This week, I really, really want you to focus on how to make time for you and get rid of the guilt. And I want you to see how much better you feel, how much happier you are when you've done something for yourself and taken care of yourself and just had that time. That it's so important to have that time for you. You feel refreshed and energized, and you just feel like you've taken care of yourself, and I bet you're happier. So that's just a tip of the week that I really, really want you to pay attention to it and start to journal. So I told you I wanted you to get a journal because we're gonna start doing a few things. I want you to journal about that. I want you to journal and pencil in your calendar when it is you're either gonna work out or, I keep saying work out because that's my thing, but and that's also because that was part of the Busy Moms Challenge group that kind of pulled you in was, needing to lose some weight and take control of your health and fitness once again. So I'm going to keep using that, but you can use this in all other areas of your life, not just health and fitness, but let's focus on that right now. So, schedule in your workout, know what you're going to do, push play on that DVD. And if it has to go around, your schedule during the week, just because Monday you can do it at this time, Wednesday you can do it at this time, and Friday you can do it at this time, and it's all over the place, that's fine. The more you do it on a regular basis at the same time each day, then that becomes a habit. But I understand that you can't do, not everybody can do that. Even I can't do that. Some days there are totally different times of the day. And I teach insanity classes a couple times a week. So that just kind of messes me up as well. So, it's all over the place. But as long as I know when I'm doing it and what workout I'm doing, I do it. I feel much better about it. So Do that, schedule it, work it out. And I want you to write down and journal how you feel about yourself when you've done something good for you. How do you feel? Do you feel like you're in more control? Do you feel like you're doing something better? Do you feel like you have a little bit more self-esteem and self-confidence? Do you have a little bit more energy and pep in your step that day? Yeah, you might be a little sore as you're working out and doing something a little different, but it's a good sore and it's a good feeling. So that's what I want you to do today. And this week is really notice that and focus on that in your journal. I also want to talk just a little bit. I'm rambling, so I don't want this to be too long to where you don't watch the videos. But I want to talk a little bit about a gratitude journal. Let's start because I want to do this for me, and I've started and stopped and not been consistent. So I really want to work with you guys on this too. For me, I want us to write every night just five things in a journal. The things that we're grateful for that day. And all I hear about every person that I follow, everybody that I love that is just full of positivity and energy and optimism, and their life is just going fun and crazy and they're just so happy. They keep gratitude journals and they're just full of all the things that they love about life. And what I know for me, when I do focus on the positive and I do notice all of the little things. It can be big things at first. I'm happy for my home and I'm thankful for my job and I'm thankful for my family and the health. And then, once you kind of get past that, the next night, think of something else. And you'll start noticing more and more little things through the day that you're happy about. Somebody held the door open for you at Starbucks. How nice was that? Or somebody let you in the traffic. I mean, the more you start noticing all the little things that you're happy about, your life tends to get happier and more fulfilling, and you want to look for the things to be happy about so you can write it down. And we're gonna start with five, but I bet we'll start adding more. So I just want to start with that. And so let's start, journaling about when we're taking care of ourselves and putting ourselves first and how we feel. And then I want us each night to write just five things we're thankful for this week. Each night, let's do that. Let's focus on that. And then I just want to give you a preview of a couple things. I don't make these stuff up, and none of this is rocket science. None of this is anything I've come up with. We've all heard all of these things before. And it's just, I'm just putting it in a place for us to just talk about it and do it because it's something that I know I want and need. And if you want to be here with me, this is what I want to focus on in my life right now. And so I've gotten a lot of this information, of course, from other people I follow, lots of books that I've read, and I've just taken pieces and parts of the things that hit me and I understand and I appreciate, and it just kind of hits me to where it's something that I can do. So I'm going to tell you about all of these things, and then I'm going to share you all the bits and pieces. So you can pick what you like or don't like to, or just tweak it and change it to what you want to do. But there's two books that I've really made a, not just two, but two recently that have made a really big impact on my life. And one's called The Compound Effect by Darren Hardy. And the other is Eat That Frog by Brian Tracy. And I don't want you to necessarily go about and buy these or anything like that. That's not what this is about. But I'm just going to tell you that I'm going to share a lot of information with you from these two books that I've really, really learned a lot from, as well as Chalene Johnson. She kind of combines a couple of these, a lot of these concepts into a book that she has called Push. And she does podcasts. You might want to look at her Facebook page, Chalene Johnson, or her website, chalenejohnson.com. And I get a lot of this stuff from her because I think she's just amazing, amazing woman. She's about my age. She's created an empire in the fitness industry and personal development. And I've really, really learned a lot from her through Beachbody because, that's where she sells all of her products. So I've learned a lot from her and I've met her and just a wonderful woman. So anyway, I'm just about at 10 minutes here. So I want to wrap up so that you guys, don't sit at your computer all night and listen to me talk. So anyway, just replay this if you want to. Grab your journal, make time for yourself, schedule your workouts, plan your meals, and let's write down five things tonight that we're thankful for. And then I'll be back tomorrow. So I want you to write down below after you see the video that you've seen it and what you think about it. If you have any questions, if there's anything you want to be sure that I do talk about and touch upon. And if you have any tips for me, because I'm a rambler and I feel like I just want to talk to you, like you guys are just my friends. So that's what I'm doing. And you can stop playing it and not listen to me, and that's totally fine. It's not going to hurt my feelings. I just want to just share and talk, and that's all I'm doing. So thanks for joining me at my house tonight to talk to me for about 10 minutes. Hope you guys have a nice evening, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.